Hey, yo! Beer review time, coming at you live from Vua Beer. What's the address? Wintiminkai?
Wintiminkai.
Yeah. Shout out to Kat Marshall, man of the ones and twos. Thank you, Kat. Special guest reviewer, Anthony Shimoshkomish.
Shimoshkomish.
Thank you. I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing that correctly. Anthony, thanks for jumping on. As is tradition, please tell the folks at home what you do for a living here in Saigon.
I'm working as a manager for Carlsberg in South of Vietnam. For now.
Sorry, just real quick, it's a little loud in here, so you might need to project
a
little
bit. Oh, so I'm working as a manager for the South of Vietnam for Carlsberg.
Carlsberg, Vietnam!
Yep.
Love it. Is there anyone you want to say hello to before we get started?
Mom, I love you.
That's sweet.
And your?
Mom, I love you.
Well, yes. Alright, so have you seen some of the beer reviews?
Yeah.
Okay.
One,
so,
one or two.
Okay, so we do one sip,
yep.
We give it a score 0 through 10,
yep.
And we do one a day until we do them all. And what we have here today is, from what I understand, one of the classic OG craft beers from America, Blue Moon Belgian White Ale. 5.4% alcohol by volume, established 1995, brewed with orange peel for a refreshing citrus taste. We'll be the judge of that. Please drink responsibly, blah, blah, blah. Best before, it is well within date, so this should taste good. Let me just in case. With the white elves, you know, shake them up a little bit. In the immortal words of the boat warrior T. Swift, let's fucking go. What's Kat doing?
Double shots.
Just taking a photo of the video? We love it. Shout out to my guy, Quickman Quan, owner operator here at Vuabia, former Pastor Street sales rep. Branching out, opening his own craft beer bar deep in the heart of Saigon. It's thick, it's hazy.
Yep.
Thank you so much. If I can remember the ad real quick, one of my favorite podcasts, they had a, like, Blue Moon was like a guest advertising spot. Because good beer deserves to be drunk more than once in a Blue Moon.
Because?
No free ads. Let's fucking go. Everybody knows the rules. Let's go. Yeah, it smells super citrusy. Are you a wheat beer guy? Like the style, do you generally like? Yeah, it's not my favorite either. So let's see how this goes.
It's powerful.
It smells super powerful. One sip, everybody knows the rules. Okay. I have thoughts. Do you want me to go first, or do you want to talk about it?
Go first.
For me, like, the up front, there is that a lot of citrus, like, on the nose, then, like, dies real quick.
Yeah.
Like, there's nothing... Yeah, there's nothing interesting on the finish. It's just, like, it's like you get that initial burst, and then it... And then it just dies real quick. One sip, everybody knows the rules. And then...
The nose is super powerful.
Yeah. The more I smell it, the less I like it.
It smells like musky product.
Musky is the right word, yes. Yeah. When I first smelled it, it was like, oh, citrusy. And then I smelled it again, it was like, oh, citrusy, and then a little funk, a little extra funk on the aroma, which, yeah, musky is a good way to describe it. Huh, alright, well. One sip, everybody knows rules.
Goes down,
straight. Yeah, so I mean, so there are two ways to say that. There's a nice way to say it, like, it finishes really smooth, or the bad way to say it is, like, the finish just dies, there's nothing much going on. So, I feel
you
like it's...
The first option or second
option? I'm leaning towards the former. I feel like I can see why some people would really like this and drink a lot of it. For me, there's not a lot going on. It's fine. It's not bad. It's certainly not bad. But it's not great. Yeah, it is what it is. So, the guest always scores first. We can talk it out a bit more, or you can just tell the people what you think.
On 10?
0 through 10, yeah.
6.
6.0, rookie score.
I rated that score on the whole Garden Rose. They got mad at me.
Right, so that was one of the biggest discrepancies between scores, was me and Kat. She gave a 6 to the Hoegaarden Rosé, I gave it like a 3. It was bad. This is not bad, but it's also not. It's not great. One sip of Riddles and Rules. So my scale is like 5 and below is like throw it down the drain.
Okay.
5 to 6 is like.
Okay.
All right, I'll drink it. So, yeah, 6 to 7 is like, oh, it's okay, and then beyond. So we don't. Well, I don't have to describe anything above that because it's not getting anywhere.
So you're between 6 and 7, right?
For this,
yeah.
I think I'm below a 6.
Oh, okay.
And I'd be interested to like taste it fresh in the States and see if it tastes any different. But again, it's well within date, so the shelf life shouldn't be an issue. I got a 5.8 on that.
5.8?
Yeah.
I mean, did you say to me that you had the right to...
Well, hey man, you said you've seen some of the reviews. We do the same thing every day for 200 plus days. But your first score is locked in. 6.0 rookie score from Anthony.
Yes.
5.8 Blue Moon. It's not terrible.
It is what it is.
It is what it is. True words have never been spoken. Anyone else you want to say hello to before we get going?
Mom, I love you.
Very diplomatic. That's a review.